Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the internet. This is Rendog coming at you from the crow's nest of the Silkworm Gang Island Fort on a very freaking rainy day in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. In the previous episode, we looted the jazz out of abandoned mineshafts, and in this episode, my friends, we are going to start work on the Silkworm Gang Railway Station, as well as the ramps that are going to be leading from the station to the main fort area. So sit back and relax, my cyber-diggity dogs. Let's play some Minecraft Survival. Now guys, I have just literally got back to the Silkworm Gang Island Fort. The rain is coming down in buckets, but I am one happy freaking cyberdog right now, man, because I have managed to collect a ridiculous amount of oak wood planks, a butt ton of fencage, a good amount of gold and a good amount of iron, and even a little bit of lapis, and some emeralds, some gold, a few diamonds. Man, this has been one epic looting session, and I'm pretty sure we now have enough resources to actually finish the Silkworm Gang Island Fort completely. I really hope so. The abandoned mineshaft is actually it's actually not that far away. There is an entrance into the cave system that leads to the abandoned mineshaft in the ocean, just off the coast of the Silkworm Gang Island Fort here. And there is a hole in the ocean that you can go down to get to the mineshafts. So if we do actually need a few more fences and a few more of these oak plankages, we can actually head back and get those. But man, I just want to drop off some of the sweet ass loot over here. And in today's episode, guys, we are going to be working on the structure of the Silkworm Gang Island Railway Station over there. Now that we have enough plankage, we should be able to do it. But the first thing that I need to do in this episode is head over to the Oakwood Grove and collect a bit of oak wood loggage, because we're going to need a whole butt ton of logs to complete the actual the platforms over there of the railway station. So I'm gonna drop all of this jazz off. You can see that my diamond axe is basically almost broken. The diamond pickaxe is definitely almost broken. And you know what? I'm gonna use a few of these diamonds to repair this diamond pickaxe. We're gonna need this diamond pickaxe to harvest a whole bunch of oak wood luggage. So I'm gonna spend 3 diamonds on this sucker. We got 1 diamond left, unfortunately, but diamonds are not the most important thing on Silkworm Gang Island. Plankage, fencage, and foodage. Those are the most important things for us on Silkworm Gang Island. And as it's raining, I'm not entirely sure whether it's nighttime or not. Let's have a try. No, it is not nighttime yet, so we have a few more minutes, I guess, to get down to the Oakwood Grove and pick ourselves up some luggage. So I'm going to head down there, guys. I don't think I've actually shown it to you yet. Oh, wait, no, I did show it to you, right? Okay, awesome, guys. So I'll tell you what. You guys have already seen the Oakwood Grove, so I'm going to plan this bad boy. I'm going to go cut down all of those Oakwood trees, replant them, and then bring you cyber-diggity dogs back, and we will start working on the actual platform and the roof of the Silkworm Gang Railway Station. So, guys, I will see you on the other side of this very lumberjacky kaplan. Kaplan! Alright, cyberdogs, welcome back to the Silkworm Gang Railway Station. I've just got back from the Oakwood Grove and I managed to harvest for myself about 110 oakwood logs, which is a pretty good yield, I think, for a grove. And if we run out of oakwood logs, we can just head back there. I replanted all of the saplings again, and I hear a freaking zombie around here, man. And that zombie's gonna drive me cray cray. We need to take him down to Chinatown. There he is! Ah, bastard! awesome. Well, before I went off on that abandoned mineshaft hunt, guys, I used the last of our oakwood logs to start work on the platform itself over here. And as you can see, it's looking pretty awesome. We still have a little bit of work to do around here. I brought with us all of the fencage, all of the leaves, and all of the logs, and some of this plankage also, so that we can try and finish off this project. And what I've done is put a layer of leaves underneath the oakwood logs to try and make it look a little bit more realistic from down under. So like when you're looking up at the railway station over here, you know, I want it to look like it's in a tree. I don't want it to just look like a wooden square on top of a tree kind of thing. But what we do need to do though is make a little drop hole over here. I think that should work, right? Yeah, I think that should work. I don't know where our minecart is. I think I sent it down the hill over here. So let's go and collect it and have a try. What we can also do in today's episode, guys, is make some sweet-ass redstone-powered rails, or redstone torches and some powered rails, and power up this spiral railway line over here too. So I'm looking forward to that, man. Oh, this is so awesome. I can't wait to get this railway station complete. It's going to be so sweet. It's like, I don't know, man, it's like, I've been thinking about the design of the station for so freaking long now that I just can't wait to get it finished. We got 21 bits of bread left. We are kind of running out of food. Managed to eat my way through more than half of a full stack of bread on that adventure, as well as a few pieces of delicious cooked fish. And I think we found a little bit of bread in a chest also, and we've managed to munch our way through that too. So, man, let me tell you, I've never eaten as much as I eat on Silkworm Gang Island, that's for shiz. And that's because there's no freaking steakage around here, man. Like, life without steak, it's no life at all. all right, so let's give this a go, guys. Let's see if this minecart will actually go down that little hole. Bam! Sweet. All right, so that works absolutely perfectly. Now, I don't want to make the station too massive, because if we make it too big, it's going to look kind of weird from a distance, right? Because the trunk of the tree that it sits on is going to be super thin. It's going to basically look like a giant ass mushroom. So I thought what we would do is make it like 3 blocks wide in all of the directions. And then what we could do is make like a little border like this, right? Of logs facing in this direction. And this is actually facing the wrong way. No! Every log is valuable. Oh no, it did a drop down. Oh, my bad. but we'll make like a little border of logs like this all the way around, and then when we get to the corners like this, we can then make a structure like this, very much like we did for the fort over there. So very much in that same design over there. So and it looks like the way that I did it there was 2 layers worth of. Yeah, I think we'll just. I'm gonna get this entire circumference of loggage installed, guys, and on the other side of this kaplam, I'll bring you back and we will have a look at what we're working with. I'll see you on the other side of this kaplam, my friends. Kaplam! Alright, Cyberdogs, welcome back! I have just finished putting up the foundations for the wall of the Silkworm Gang Railway Station, and I've also peeled off my sweaty-ass iron armor. I'm starting to stink like an infected villager up in here, man, and it ain't pretty! The cats don't even want to come and hang out with me at the moment, man. And that's how much I stink. But I've also headed back to the Oakwood Grove to do a little bit more groving, I guess, because I ran out of wood. So I've managed to collect another stack and a little bit of oak wood. And this is looking pretty awesome. And now what I want to do now, guys, is basically do exactly what we did in the Silkworm Gang Fort, and that is make the Etho roof. And the way that we made the Etho roof was with stairs, and with leaves, right? So the plan is to fill the entire top of the roof over here with leaves like this. So we fill the roof like so, and then we make some stairs out of the plankage that we managed to pillage from the abandoned mineshaft, because we're allowed to do that, of course. And then what we do is we line the entire roof like this with this awesome like stair skirting over here. And this is the design that Etho, one of my favorite Minecrafters, uses. So I'm pretty happy to use it in the station. And then what we'll do is on top of the leaves, put a layer of plankage and then cover the whole lot of that in plankage. And that should give the illusion of a tree house kind of thing like we have with the fort over there. So tell you what, guys, I'm going to crack on with getting this roof installed. And then I'll bring you guys back on the other side of this kaplam. But before I do, guys, I just want to say, man, it is such a beautiful day in London today. The sun is out again. We've had such amazing freaking weather for the last week or so. And I am moving to a new place on Friday. Today is Monday, so I am literally moving in about 5 days' time. It's been pretty crazy around here, man. I've had to pack up all my jazz, had to sort out all of that sort of stuff. I've put a little bit of stuff in storage, some of my furniture, because I'm moving into a room with some housemates, and I'm not going to have enough space for all of my sweet real-life loots. Now, the only thing I am worried about is internet, man. There is going to be internet in the house, and I'm told by the landlord that it's going to be the best internet that that we can get for the area. So I'm pretty confident that we're going to have pretty fast internet, but I will be sharing my internet with a whole bunch of other humans and a whole bunch of other laptops, phones, iPhones, Androids, freaking tablets. Who knows how many devices are going to be sucking juice from my freaking Wi-Fi, man. But I guess only time will tell. I guess if worse comes to worse, we'll have to start uploading. I won't be able to upload like 1080 HD Minecraft videos anymore. I think we'll have to stick to 720, but that won't be, I don't think that'll be too bad of a blow, but we will see what happens, man. And man, I can't wait to like record my very first video from my very first, from my new room. It's gonna be awesome, and I'm gonna do it this weekend, actually, and it's gonna be sweet, man. I'll let you guys know as soon as I'm recording from my new freaking room. I'll be like, hey, Cyber Dogs, this is Rendog coming at you from my brand new room. That's gonna be sweet. But as you can see, man, the roof is looking awesome. I'm just gonna get all of this lining installed, get a layer of plankage put on top of these leaves over here, guys. I'll bring you back on the other side of this. Compliant. All right, Cyber Dogs, welcome back. I have just finished laying down some plankage on top of the leaves that make up the Etho roof over here. And as you can see, it is looking freaking sweet in this station, man. I've also laying down some fencage around here to try and like make a nice safety perimeter. So let me just quickly finish that off like this. So this is looking pretty awesome, man. You know, we don't need this station to be absolutely massive. We just need it to be kind of cool. Like, I really like what it feels like in here, right? Like, it's a nice small station. It makes sense. You know where you're going. Maybe what we could do is lay down some fences like this in between the platforms, like this. Just for safety's sake, man. This is purely for health and safety over here. When kids come to Silkworm Gang Island, we do not want them falling down and killing themselves straight down that drop hole over there. This is like the most dangerous station on the face of the planet. But there you go, man. Yeah, that's looking sweet. Okay, there we go. So this is the departures lounge, and this is the arrivals lounge up in here. Awesome. That's looking sweet, man. Maybe what we could do is like build up this pillar all the way to the top. I mean, just for the lulz, really. Like, just to try something different, right? Yeah, there we go. That looks pretty sweet. It's kind of like the pillar that holds up this whole place, right? Yeah, that looks pretty sweet. Like, maybe we can even try and make it a little bit more attractive. Let's change the bottom and the top of the pillar to logs. Let's try and make it a little bit more aesthetically pleasing, right? Like, every station has some sort of a centerpiece in it. You know, like, whether it's a clock or a statue or something. And in the Silkworm Gang Railway Station, we've got a pylon of wood. That's what we got going on over here, man. But that looks pretty sweet, actually. What we need to do now, guys, is get some torches up in here, because it is pretty freaking dark. I've also gone back to the fort and collected our redstone that we got on our journey, as well as the powered rails that we made before we went on the abandoned mineshaft hunt. So now we can actually make for ourselves some redstone torches. Why do I always want to make redstone torches out of normal torches? Man, such a butthole. Anyway, guys, let's get some torches on the corners over here like this. Just to make sure that this place has got a bunch of fire. No zombies and freaking skelebuts can spawn up in this jazz. And I think we should make like a... Yeah, let's make like little light features like this on each of the pillars. Yeah, that'd be pretty sweet. We're actually running out of coal. Which is not good. In fact, we're not going to have enough torches to torch up these little features here. And the reason for that is I had found a ton of coal on that adventure, but I actually threw it out of my inventory to make more space for plankage and fences. I instantly regret my decision. Alright, so we need one more torch to complete this corner of light over here. Make that two more torches. Alright, so the next task for us over here, guys, is to actually get the powered rails installed into the spiraling railway line over here. We also need to install the last little bit of fencage over here also. And I think what I'm going to do is, because I don't know if you guys are aware, but rails are actually changing quite dramatically in Minecraft 1.8. This tree... What kind of a physics fail is this, man? This entire station has been resting on the strength of freaking leaves. Man, that is some epic fails right over there. Right, let's complete the trunk of this tree, man. There we go. And in 1.8, powered rails are going to be much more powerful. So when you hit a powered rail in a minecart, it is going to freaking shoot you super fast along the railway line that you're on. But on top of that, there is a new derailing mechanism in 1.8, where if you're going too fast, you will actually, your minecart will derail and you will fall off the rail journey that you're on. So what we need to make sure, we need to preemptively design for 1.8, right? And the way that we've designed the railway line so far is, I think it's like every 20 blocks or so, we have a powered rail. But I think that's at like this over here, right? In 1.8, this would literally ramp us off this freaking little ramp over here straight, and our head would just go straight into the tree and we'd probably die, because these two powered rails will like generate ridiculous amounts of speed. So we've got to be a little bit careful with how we place powered rails now. And I think what I'm going to do is like, I'm just going to put them like one every two spirals or so. So we'll install the powered rail like this, and we'll put our redstone torch in there. So let's just make some stickage. And some redstone torches. Yeah, that should be enough redstone torches, I think. And then we'll do this like every, let's see, one, two, three. We can do it, okay, we'll do it on every side that faces the ocean over here, right? Yeah, that makes sense to me. Okay, sweet guys. Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to get these powered rails installed. I'm also going to have to head back to the fort to have a sleep now. And I will catch you guys on the other side of this kaplam. We'll have and we will test out this new system to see if we can actually get ourselves all the way up the spiral staircase via the power of redstone rails. See you on the other side of this kaplam, my friends. Kaplam! All right, Cyberdogs, welcome back to the window of my bedroom in the Silkworm Gang Island Fort. And I've just been standing over here admiring the view of the railway station. I think it's looking pretty sweet, man. I love the, like, spiraling railway line that goes around the tree. I think that looks absolutely awesome. We still need to add a little patch of leaves there to the roof of the railway station. I actually turned some of our oak wood planks into some oak wood slabbage to try and preserve our oak wood planks. Obviously, we have a finite amount of these and we still have a huge fort to build. So I thought that was quite a smart way to preserve those oak wood planks. And if we can make freaking stairs, why can't we make slabbage? Am I right? I've also tweaked the railway line slightly. In my preliminary tests, there wasn't enough power to actually get us up that spiral. I've also connected the railway line to the underwater tunnel, guys. So guess what? We are going to be able to test this bad boy out right now. We're going to be able to find out whether or not the departures platform and the arrivals platform of the Silkworm Gang Island Station works, and works as sweetly as we would hope. So let's do this thing, guys. I can't guarantee that this is going to work, but let's give it a freaking go, man. All right, so we are leaving Silkworm Gang Island. We should ramp through that hole, land on the railway line, and get taken down into the underwater tunnel. If all goes to plan, that's exactly what should happen. The rampage has just happened, and looks like we're landing one block too far back. So what we'll do is extend the ramp over there in the railway station itself. And it looks like we're getting stuck over here for some reason. Maybe one of these leaves is stopping us. That's very curious, man. I'm not entirely sure why we're getting stuck in this position over here. Is it this leaf? Is it this leaf? All right, there we go. It looked like it was that redstone torch. All right, sweet. So that looks like it's almost working. The departures platform is almost working. Now we're going to test the arrivals platform. This is the more important one, obviously, to see if our little spiral railway line is actually going to work the way that we want it to. So what I've actually had to do is add another powered rail to the back of the tree. There definitely wasn't enough power going around the spiral itself. So let's have a look. And looks like we get stuck in that corner. And as you guys can see, I've added another redstone torch and powered rail to the back of the tree at every spiral around the back. And I'm not holding forward or anything like that. And it looks like our railway line is pushing us all the way up to the arrivals. So that works absolutely freaking beautifully, except for the bottom. For some reason, we get stuck over there. But as you can see, guys, I've added another powered rail and redstone torch to the back side of the tree, all the way down on every single level of the spiral. But for some reason, the departures platform is not very happy. I think what we need to do is just open this up a little bit and then add one more railway line like this. And that should get us landing on that powered rail down there, right? So let's give this one more go and then try and fix the bottom over there too. No, that's cute, but it is freaking wrong. All right, let's try this one more time, guys. I don't mind doing this, man. It's so fun. All right, here we go. So ramp, and now we should land on the ramp. There we go. Beautiful. And yes, I fixed the problem over there getting stuck in the tunnel. So that's absolutely perfect. Now, all we need to do is fix up that little corner right at the bottom of the railway spiral. Minecart, you freaking butthole. Oh, man, minecart's driving me freaking cray-cray, man. All right, well, let's just take it back, shall we? And then we can get off at the point where we get stuck. Man, that is looking so sweet. Like, the station is definitely looking less natural than the fort. But I kind of like it that way, actually. All right, so we are getting stuck right here on the corner. And it's probably, like, all of these leaves that are stopping us. It's probably, like, this vinage or so. Let's just, like, clear away a bit of the leaf area over here. Maybe it's this... that freaking fence over there. All right, let's try one more time, man. Let's do it from here. Yeah, there we go. And now, I'm not holding shift. My hands are off the keyboard, my friends. And we are going all the way up the tree. Oh, just ran out of gas. And now we're going all the way down the freaking tree. Oh, my goodness gracious, man. But all in all, it freaking works, okay? It looks like we run out of juice just as we go around the corner there. I'm not entirely sure why that's happening. I think it might be because we started a little bit too early. Like, we weren't going at full tilt when we actually hit the spiral itself. So, let's try that one more time, right? So, here we go. Going all the way up. And we kind of run out of steam as we get to each powered rail, right? Check it out. As we get to the powered rail, we get another boost. So, that actually works really, really nicely. All right, sweet. That is working just the way that I like it. That is awesome, man. And I think the railway station is starting to take shape quite nicely. Like, the next task that I'm going to be doing, guys, is creating a platform down from the station to that canopy over there, and then a bridge across to the main part of Silcomgang Island over there. And then we're going to be making a wall all the way around the top of this little mountain face over here. And then that is going to be the wall of Silcomgang Island. But guys, we have run out of time for today's episode. I really hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you have, you know what to do, man. You hit that like freaking button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you hit that freaking subscribe button. Because guess what, guys? We are 10 episodes away from season 4. And that is freaking crazy, man. I just cannot wait. It's going to be awesome. So if you haven't subscribed yet, man, you hit that subscribe button with a freaking vengeance. This has been Ren Diggity Dog playing Minecraft Survival. Thank you so much for watching, my friends. We will see you in the next video. Goodbye, everybody!